I am going to briefly say the description and achievements. Dr. Kulkarni is the head of his School of Computing at Asia Pacific Institute of Information Technology, received his PhD and MS in field of computer science, University of California. And then Mr. Asas Kasturiarak is a software engineer, industrial and financial system, Sri Lanka, and graduating with BSc in computer science this year from Asia Pacific Institute of Information Technology. The title already we said. Let me invite, I think it is Mr. Asas Kasturiarak is presenting him. I don't know.
Good evening, everyone. Dear Chairperson and all the members of the organizing committee, as well as all of you, thank you for this opportunity. And it's a great opportunity for me and for us as from the University of Staffordshire with representing Asia Pacific Institute of Information Technology. First of all, as the Chairperson has introduced, I am Yasas Kasturiarak, and my supervisor CRD is Dr. Dhananjay Kulkarni. This is a new inventive software that we have developed and researched, so we would be introducing it here alongside the presentation. So let me get into the presentation. Okay. On my research on the final year project, I did a research based on determining suspects or objects in crime scene investigation. Mainly it's on person identification. And based on the research, I developed a tool for determining suspects or objects in crime scene investigation, and the tool was named as Forensic Determiner. And moving into the agenda of this presentation, initially I'll be going through the current situation of a crime scene investigation and the problem statement I have identified, as well as the solution outlining that I would be presenting. At the latter part of the presentation, I would be going through my solution and how it was made and how useful it would be to the modern society, as well as for the crime scene investigations. The current challenges we all see in usual crime scene investigation would be the inaccuracy and inefficiency of a criminal identification. Also, there are limitations arising in the use of mechanical or non-technical devices, as well as unavailability of a suitable image database, as well as there is no single application that could drive through a forensic field of investigation. About the problem statement is the inability of accurately recognizing a person based on information technological system. The solution that I'm presenting is accurate person identification with the use of face recognition, object recognition, image differentiation, facial validation, and boundary-based recognition. This is encompassed with enhanced systematic functionalities, database connectivity, delivering all required information, as well as having a well-designed and developed application that would all integrate all these features together. Moving into the project objectives, as mentioned previously, it would be to implement all these features together and also to achieve a 90% or more accuracy for the recognitions and a success rate for the software. And also it should be highly developed in the section of graphical user interface. Moving into the scope, it's about serving person identification or criminal identification with the use of these systems to be able to identify people or criminals based on several characteristics, external and also their belongings. My software application presents these components as a solution to the current issue: face recognition, facial validation, object recognition, and boundary-based recognition will be used for this tool. Getting into the literature review section, face recognition, as we know, is a type of pattern recognition of a person's face which is recorded in a database for future attempts to determine the identity of the person when the face is viewed for clarification at a later stage. Facial validation differs from face recognition, but most of us do not have the clear understanding of it. It's a process of matching known individuals from face between each other and making sure what differences it would arise with the similarity it has. Face recognition and facial validation were implemented using Argent Faces or PZA algorithm, while face detection was implemented using Weiler-Jones algorithm with HAR-based cascade classifiers. This is just a view of or a glimpse of my application with related to face recognition. There are further more details that are to come. I will show it in the demonstration. Facial validation could be taken into account where you would be comparing two faces of this for the similarity, and the most matched image would be taken as an accurate guess for the recognition. Moving into object recognition, this was implemented using SURF algorithm, and as we know, it's about to get a known image content through another image, so we could find a match through image database in order to get a better accurate match for an object recognition. Boundary-based recognition was implemented for shoe print recognition. This was implemented using time series and dynamic time warping algorithm. Image differentiation was divided into scene differentiation and object differentiation. This happens based on the image contents and its similarity. The architecture used for the development was MVC architecture, and the programming environment was Java. OpenCV and JavaCV, as well as Java Advanced Imaging Libraries, were very helpful, and the mentioned algorithms were used as mentioned previously. Testing was done, unit integration and validation testing. Based on the testing, we were able to find out on critically evaluating the software that the software could go above and beyond the 90% of success rate, and based on overall software, it could go at a rate of 90%, and several components like face recognition went up above 95% of accuracy. The overall solution presented is of high standard because the results produced are accurate, effective, and efficient. Next, I would like to go into my application and demonstrate it. This will be the welcome screen that a detective would see once he logs into the application. On login, he will or she will get several components that he or she could test within. Either of these single components could be used, or else combination of techniques could be used for a better investigation. First, let me go into image differentiation under the scene differentiation and show you an example of image differentiation. The scenario I'm trying to come with is that of captured images taken from CCTV cameras. The effect takes place before and after a crime scene. So without wasting your time, a detective can simply input an image of captured from a crime scene and investigate what the difference would be. The blood stains would be a clear evidence or icon catching feature, but however, we might not be able to detect the foreign objects within it. So we could easily get it into this one and move into this frame where we could use some image enhancing properties like brightness, contrasting, or converting black and white. One other feature I have implemented is cropping the images as required. So considering this to be a foreign object, I would like to go into object differentiation section, where the most closest object out of the differentiated image will be presented at the top, or you can see there's a deviation given. Based on the deviation, you could manually select or get the most accurate image into your next progression. And I have recorded particular images, image content with a suspect, so by pressing on display matches, you could get suspects involved or associated with this kind of an object or in scene. You could view the profile by typing the suspect ID. Best because of the time interval, I might not be going through that. Just to show you another feature. I have enabled viewing more details on this. That means a detective could easily view more details on this. So if there are any criminal organizations or gangs involved in a crime, you could easily detect it based on the object you have found already. Next, I would be validating the image. That means I'll be moving back to the previous scene, but now I have a better image captured to me. So I could now enhance image as required, but for the moment I would move into object recognition, load it into this panel, and match any image contents that has something to do with this object that I have in hand. So as a result of that, you can see there is a one guess that was found out. And for the current position, I have found out 3 manual guesses you could go up to, because at times it will be pretty hard to detect a face based on just if some case like this, he's wearing a mask, so it's pretty difficult to find that case. So for the moment, I will download these 2 images. You can easily download it from here. I have downloaded it already. So next, I would be going for a face recognition, but continuing the process. Next thing is boundary-based recognition. I'll just quickly add it into that. In boundary-based recognition, I have developed shoe print recognition based on boundary-based recognition. And what happens here is the shoe print that is taken in as a print could be matched against another image collection of databases of shoe prints, and the best match and the percentage match could be found out. You could find out any suspects involved with this kind of a shoe print. For example, as previously mentioned, you could type in the ID of the person and view his profile. You get all the information of his, who has been wearing or has been in association with this kind of a shoe print. And next, I would like to move into face recognition to continue the previous approach. Here, I would like to show the captured image from object recognition being taken into effect. This is one of the matches that I found out for with an accuracy of 72.71%, and there are 3 possible matches that I have enabled, so it could lead to a better recognition. This is the second match of 69.95%, and as for the 3 matches, the last one is 69.41%. You could download all these images together. If required, you could view them close by for manual identification of the criminal as well, for easiness. You could directly view this profile. If you think this could be a suspect, you could go ahead and view him. And another feature that I have added up is, based on the stride length, there's a regression formula. You could find out the height of the person. If you have stored the height of the person, in this case I have stored it as 5.95. For example, if we find out from the scene of crime that the stride length of the person was 2.54 feet, we could estimate his height to be 6.12. Or in likewise, in the, such case, you could match up with the height of the person with the height association with the image database. All the other image and as well as information would be valuable in this aspect. Moving into facial validation, the face recognition was the process that I did initially, but next I would be going for facial validation, in which case I would get a similarity match of 73.23%. This is based on facial validation. You could manually check it by yourself as well, whether how similar it could be, but the technical answers could be efficient. And just to go through the other process as well, on matching the second image, I could show you that based on face recognition, we retrieve the results. But facial validation would give us a better accurate result in matching. So here on, it's giving me 91.95% of accuracy. So that's basically it. If anyone is interested, you can come and meet me or talk over this. We are trying to improve this. This is just an innovation of and things going on. So I would like to improve and introduce this software application more in detail. So thank you very much, everyone, for coming and viewing this, and thank you.